Hello, welcome. Welcome, everybody. Welcome to this Good Friday class. And you're probably asking yourself why I said Good Friday. Claro, es un buen viernes. Isn't every Friday a Good Friday? I thought so. But also today is Good Friday because it's a holiday. You guys call it Viernes Santo. We call it Good Friday. So happy Good Friday to you all. Or if you want to use a double trouble, have a good, good Friday. Toma! All right, well, guys, welcome to the Instagram Live. As promised, a lot of you asked me in the direct messages and in the comments why I don't do Instagram Lives more often. And the answer is really simple. I do 10 hours on Instagram Live every week. 10 hours. Yeah, I know. I can't believe it myself. And that is, now it's not on my account. That's the thing. So if you're saying, pero donde? I don't get this. Guys, I'm on Grupo Vaughan every day. 10 hours of live streams. And speaking of, there's my buddy Rob and some of the students. There's Jimmy James. Wow, guys. Awesome sauce, as we say in the United States. Awesome sauce. Salsa genial. So yes, I'm on the air 10 hours a day here on Instagram. It's on Grupo_Vaughan. And the reason I'm telling you guys that is because I know every week I have new followers. If you already know that, great. You know who you are. It's a pleasure to have you guys on board with us every day, learning and laughing on Vaughan Radio. So that's why I don't do lives on my Instagram, because I'm lived out. To be lived out, right? Kind of made that one up. Man, sometimes I need a break from doing live shows. So that's 10 hours a week. It's called The Show With No Name. If you guys are not familiar with it, check it out. Wherever you listen to podcasts, you've got The Show With No Name. And every Monday through Friday, it's on Grupo Vaughan. So when this live stream finishes, go over to Grupo_Vaughan, Vaughan, and follow them. And then you can tune into this show and many other shows that are on Vaughan Radio. So I am on the air live every day, just not here. So that's why I decided to be here and just give you guys a little update. I always like to check in. I think you say in Spanish, fichar, to check in and see how you guys are doing, tell you about, you know, new things that are going on, novedades, and it's always great to see all your familiar names and faces. I've got some of my students from The Show With No Name, Diana, Lupe, Chris as well. Welcome, welcome, happy Good Friday to all of you. It's so nice to have you guys here with us. So that's every day. If you haven't joined us, join us one day. It's a lot of fun. As Marta says, the Show With No Namers are in the house. The Show With No Namers are here. That's right. And you'll love it. You'll get hooked on English. So that's every Monday through Friday, 10:30 a.m. And that is Madrid time. Every Friday, you have a new episode of my weekly podcast. Now, these are all things. Why am I spamming you? Or it's not really spam. I'm telling you about amazing resources, free resources to help you guys improve your English, and not just improve your English, but get hooked on it. You know, really, really get into it. And that's what we want. You know, I don't want a student who's kind of half-ass in it. And you guys know that. You guys know I'm one of the nicest guys in the world, but I'm a strict teacher. I got a lot of students, so I gotta maintain some kind of order in the court. But I'm a happy-go-lucky guy, una persona sin mucha preocupación, but I do demand the best, because my students are the best. So you guys have got that. You've got, as I said, my weekly podcast. Now, my weekly podcast is called FYI for Your English. So wherever you listen to the Vaughan podcast, The Show With No Name and all that stuff, you can find FYI. That's Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or as you say in Spain, Spotify. I love how you guys say that. Es el Spotify. Claro, de toda la vida, el Spotify. And you can catch it wherever. So that's another resource. That's once a week. You have that episode. It's usually about 30 minutes tops. And then there's a bonus part as well. And I'll tell you about the bonus part. But first, let's give it a listen. Why not? I'm telling you guys a little bit about this episode, this show, FYI. So why don't we hear the teaser? And remember, this is a great word, the word tease. Teases. You want this? Nope. You want? Nah. Tease. Vacilar, right? Tease like that. So this is a teaser, and it's the intro. And I've got to tell you, you can ask my students this. From each intro, you can probably get about 10 to 12 different words or expressions just in the intro of For Your Inglés. And this is now, let me take a look. This is, I can't believe it, the other day. This is our 44th episode. 44 episodes of FYI. So thank you so much to all of you guys for rating it, to rate us, valorar. I really appreciate that. And if you haven't done that, do that. And I'd love to send you a special gift. So I'm going to tell you about the bonus audio and all that stuff in a moment. But why don't we hear this week's episode, the teaser, and we can look at some of the vocabulary very quickly as well. And let me be honest. There are certain topics, I guess this is natural. There are certain topics that are more interesting to one person or another, naturally. So if we do one, and we're going to do one, on aviation, it's going to be a 4-hour episode, okay? I'm joking, but I am going to interview pilots, and I'm not doing that one yet. I'm holding off, as I taught you guys, hold off, esperar. So some episodes you just naturally like more, and as soon as I said boy bands, and my wife, it was her suggestion, so all of you who love the boy bands episode, you can thank my wife. She's a huge Backstreet Boys fan. And I, on the other hand, am more of an NSYNC fan. Hey, different strokes for different folks. Para gustos los colores. So, what am I getting at? ¿A qué voy? When I researched this episode, I had a lot of fun. I really enjoyed learning about the boy bands. And I thought I didn't, let's put it this way, summing up. I thought I didn't like boy bands. I love boy bands. There were many moments when I was recording the audio and I was dancing or I was doing bye, 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 bye. I don't want to be a fool for you. Just another player in this game for two. You guys, you know it? You know the lyrics? May sound crazy, but it ain't no lie, baby. Bye, 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 bye. You know it. You were singing along, see? Boys to men, oh. And now we come to the end of the road, still I can't let you go. Guys, and you know what? You know who the original boy band was? The Beatles. Hey, they made girls scream, they wrote love songs, they had a similar look kind of thing going on. Get out of town! Yeah, Jackson 5, of course. Guys, they weren't called boy bands, but they were boy bands, according to the definition. All right, so let's take a look over here, my amigos, or a listen, I should say. This is this week's episode, and as I said, it's on boy bands. I hope you like this little teaser. It's the intro of the show. Let's see if... Okay.
Although they are generally considered a flash in the pan, their staying power and popularity is ever-present. They make the masses swoon and sway as they sweep us off our feet with their swagger. FYI! We are going backstage past the buff bouncers as we blow the lid off boy bands on this week's episode of FYI. Welcome to For Your Info.
English.
You got it.
There it is, folks. So that is that's the teaser. If you want to listen to the whole episode, well, wherever you guys listen to podcasts, make sure you follow. Yeah, they stopped using the word subscribe, which I think is good, because people feel like they have to pay. And podcasts, as far as I know, are free by nature. Now, many podcasts that I know of and support. One called the Spanish Football Podcast. Well, they have that free part, and then they have another part. They have bonus stuff, and not just bonus audio, bonus content. So if you really like it, you can go deeper. Now, that's up to you. Again, you always have the free part. You always have social media. You always have my radio shows. So you got tons of stuff. But if you want to go deeper, you can. You can. And we go a little bit deeper in the second half, in the bonus audio of every week's show. It gives you another half an hour, 25 to a half an hour. Nothing, it doesn't go over a half an hour usually. And we look at key, like in the Las Vegas episode, we looked at a lot of very important gambling expressions. I shouldn't say gambling expressions. I should say gambling expressions that are used in everyday, you know, in everyday situations. So if you miss the bonus part of that, you're missing out. There's some really good vocabulary in there. And if you are, there are four different levels in my on my Patreon page. Now, what is Patreon? For those of you who don't know, Patreon is a place where you build a community and people support you and you give them special bonuses and, well, content and classes. Well, that's up to you. You have to come up with the formula, okay? Now, my formula is different than a musician's formula. And my friend Rob Grams, who came on board right now, he's an artist. Go to his Patreon page. Very different than mine. Mine teaches English. His is about art and supporting art. So it's about supporting something and receiving something. In fact, the word patron is mecena, I believe, in Spanish. Patron. And they say, Leonardo da Vinci, all of these guys, their most famous works wouldn't have been completed without patrons. So I've got Patricio. He's one of my patrons. He's an amazing student. One of my patrons, I say, but really one of my students, because as a patron, you become my student. I mean, all of you are my students, don't get me wrong. But you become like, you're in my community, my own community that I've created. And there are different levels, and I'll tell you about those levels really quickly without boring you, because a lot of this information you can find. Just go over to my Patreon page, and it's patreon.com/Alberto Alonso. And there are four tiers, okay? Cuatro niveles, let's say. Cuatro, yeah. And the first one is called the Star Students. And at the Star Student level, you get access to the podcast, obviously, the bonus audio, and you get worksheets, okay? And so the worksheets are, they basically, it's all the stuff that's being said in the podcast, but you only get it in Spanish. So you have to fill in, you got to have a good ear, and you got to fill in the blanks there. It's great because every week in those documents, those worksheets, every week you'll get over 300 words related to that topic. This week, boy bands. Last week was Harley Davidson. And as many of you know, you can hear it. I put a lot of work, I put a lot of time, I put a lot of energy into it, like everything I do. You guys know that. Whether it's Vaughn Radio, whether it's my self-produced podcast, whether it's my patron classes, whatever it is, I put my heart into it or I'm not going to do it. That's my philosophy. So it takes a lot of time. So obviously that's time I could be with my daughter, time, you know. And it's great though, because we have built this community since we started in June. That was one of my biggest worries. Concerns. Worry sounds too extreme. One of my biggest concerns was, well, I know I have a community on social media, on the radio, but how do I just create a community out of nowhere? And well, it doesn't happen like that. It's little by little. All of my students started getting to know each other. One of my students just had a baby. He's a father, first-time father. So it feels like a community. It feels like a family. And that, to me, was the most important part. Not how many people I had, and that people were enjoying the content, they were finding it useful, they were finding it helpful, and again, getting hooked on the process, on the learning process. And if you can get hooked on learning English, you can get hooked on learning anything. And that's the idea behind FYI. So why not learn about a lot of different topics while we learn English, instead of always saying, okay, present perfect continuous. Well, what if you hear the present perfect continuous talking about Las Vegas in context? See, that's what it's all about, you know. So those worksheets are very helpful. Again, you have to be got to have a good ear. Now, if you don't know a word, here's another thing. As a patron, you have access to me. You know, I don't always answer everyone, I have to say, you know. I don't answer everyone. It's impossible. Thankfully, I get so many comments, you know. And but if you're a patron, I answer. I'm guaranteed. It might take me a little bit because, well, as many of you know, I'm always busy. I'm always doing things, which is great because, again, you guys are enjoying it. So if you weren't, I probably wouldn't do it. I would pack it up and go home. Yeah. So somebody is asking me what flash in the pan means. Well, somebody didn't listen to the podcast. It's in the podcast. So you just proved to me that you didn't listen to the podcast. So I've got an idea. Person who just asked me that. Go to the podcast, hit follow or subscribe, listen to it, and then you tell me. See, I'm not going to give it to you. It's in the podcast. I already explained it to you. See, guys, it's all out there. It's all available. And of course, you can learn and have fun. Now, that's the first level. Oh, and also you have early access. So to all my posts that I do on Patreon, to the podcast, which comes out on Friday for the general public, you know. I was going to do it on Friday for the general, it comes out on Friday for the general public. Thursdays, if you guys are patrons, you get it on Thursday and you get the bonus audio on Friday. So all my patrons get bonus audio, all my patrons get the vocabulary worksheets. Now, if you're at the next level, which is the superstar student, at that level you get worksheets and you also have the vocabulary sheet. So you can check your work, right? And you can print these. They're PDF documents, okay? And these are very helpful because you can literally listen to the podcast and go through and look at the, eso se pronuncia así, pero se escribe así. Very, very useful. That's the second level, superstars, okay? So just remember, every level you go up, you always get access to the early stuff. Also at the superstar level, you'll have access to our weekly classes. And when I say that, you'll have access to the videos of the weekly classes. Let me correct that. You will be able to watch every week. We have a class where we review what we looked at in the podcast. Okay. And that's with our super duper students and our interstellar, the two highest levels. But at the superstar level, the second level, you have access to those videos. You're just not in those classes. See what I mean? So I look at it as like the first level is you want more. You want to learn more. You're hungry for more. You love the work that I do as well. And you want all that extra bonus content. The second level is very self-study. It's, you know, you're using the materials, the videos I provide every week, and you're learning on your own. Again, I'm there for any questions. The super duper level is the next level. Now at that level, you are in those classes. So at that level, you get 5 classes a week. Excuse me, whoa. 5 classes a month. Whoa, I'm like, that sounds like a lot. So you get 1 weekly class based on the episode. So this coming week, we're gonna look at our boy band episode and the vocabulary therein, ahí dentro. And in the one before, we looked at this past week, Harley Davidson. So we look at structures, we use the vocabulary, and those are my super duper students. They are spectacular. If you guys are here, Patricio being one of them, it's great because at this level, we have a relationship. Yeah, of course, I see you every week. I see you 5 times a month, at least. We talk on Patreon. So at this level, I'm involved in your English learning process much more. See the difference? It's my involvement too. Here, I'm like, here's the materials. Good luck. I'm here. This one, it's like, come on, every week, you're with me. Let's go. We've got class. So, and then the highest level, you have all that stuff, and you also can win private classes with me as well. You get greetings. Every month, I send you a special greeting Hi, keep up with some kind of tip, some kind of pointer to get you guys going, to get you guys involved. Okay, a couple questions here. I've got a lot of comments, so I'll see if we can take some questions. But join the community. We'd love to have you on board. If you'd like a sample, una muestra, just write to me. Escríbeme un correo and voila, we're done. Simple. let's see. Jimmy James says, I'm at the super duper level. Thank you, Jimmy James. And I'm learning so much. Well, I can see it. When Jimmy James participates on the show with no name, I'm like, where did you learn that vocabulary? And then I'm like, oh, wait. And he tells me, FYI, man, you taught us last week or in the, you know, the new, the pizza episode. So great job. There's an example of a wonderful student. Martha says, what's the schedule of these weekly classes on the super duper level? That is determined by my students. So every Saturday or Sunday, usually on Saturday, I send out a little survey, una encuesta, and I give you some options. And you have morning options, afternoon options, and evening. I try and do like a lunchtime slot, a morning, and an afternoon. But you guys vote. You decide the final time as a group. Now, usually, from my experience, every week it's either Monday or Tuesday at 7 p.m. But that can change depending on you guys, okay? And the monthly classes, which are also at that level, at the super duper and interstellar level, those monthly classes as well, those you vote on, but those I tend to do on the weekend. So those will be done on a weekend usually, just because this way the more the merrier. We can get as many of you to be on board as possible. The special one says, when becoming a patron, do we get access also to all the previous content that you made before? Excellent question. And the answer is yes. I love that I can say yes. That is another great thing. Let me see. I'm going to go over here to home on Patreon, and it tells me what I have here. Let's see. Creator account page. Let me go. I can give you guys view page. Okay. So I'm here on Patreon. Right now, where is this? My membership share. I know that there's a place where it says this, and I don't know where it is right now. Let's see. I'm going to look right now. But you will have access to, where is it? Here it is. If you join now. Now, it depends on your level, too. If you join at the superstar level, then you're going to get the stuff on the superstar level, not the... So remember, the stuff that's applicable, the stuff that is at your level, you'll get. All the previous stuff. So what does that mean? That's 44 episodes of FYI. 44 episodes. How many... Well, add that together. Vocabulary sheets. You've got tons of content already. And that's another thing I was concerned about. I said, listen, you know, how do you create a community from nowhere? And we're doing it. We're doing it. We're proving that you get a good group of people together who all have stuff in common, and we're rolling. We, you know, it's a great group. As I said, I'm really, really happy. So, and the other thing was having a database of content, you know, having some kind of database where when you came on board, there was more than one post. But of course, that takes time. Like on my social media, there's hundreds of posts. And if you guys are, obviously you're following me on Instagram because you're here. So thank you very much, by the way. And if you guys ever spread the word, if you're like, you know, listening to the podcast and you take a picture, like, you know, taking notes or something that will motivate other students, I will share that. I would be more than happy. If you know, you at the gym, like, escuchando FY, mention me. Because that's the kind of pose I think that not just make me happy, but they motivate your fellow students as well. And I think that's a big part of community too. That I'm not the only one motivating Patricio or Jose Maria. What's up, buddy? Some of my super duper students over here. They're motivating each other too. So that's something that's priceless. You cannot put a price on that. MJ says, FYI, your classes are not just for students. They also inspire teachers, and they get such cool ideas and vocabulary. Well, that's another thing, too. Teachers have asked me, I want to use your, you know, I want to sign up, but what do I do? Well, what I would recommend in that case, if you're going to be using the material and duplicating it, you know, I would recommend you go, you join on a higher level, because remember, you know, it's eso se llama pirateo if you do it too much. So be fair. That's all I'm saying. Just remember, I wake up early. I go to sleep late. I put my heart and soul, ask my wife, into everything I do. So just remember that when you're thinking, huh, well, I'm going to copy this and pass it to all my friends for free. Just remember, that was time I could have been with my daughter. Okay. Let's see. Brian says, I listen to Vaughn Radio because of you. You're the best. Keep it up. I'd like to participate more, but I can't. Don't worry. As long as you're doing the exercises, that's great. So I have to settle for watching or listening to your podcast. Guys, remember, that is the lovely thing about podcasts. Podcasts are things that you can listen to anywhere, anytime. You can be on a plane, you can be in the bathroom, and you can kind of be doing other things. Now, of course, if you're learning English, you might want to focus on that, right? But in general, the format, that's why this format of podcasts has just really blown up. And to blow up is explotar, hacerse muy grande. So that's a little bit, that's some of the stuff you've got. You got tons of free stuff. You can join my community. One of the cool things, speaking of supporting each other, I feel so lucky to have friends. I want to send a shout out now to two teachers, speaking of teachers, who are patrons of mine. They don't have to be. They speak English. They're patrons of mine as a show of support. And I will forever be thankful to them, because they don't need it. It's an extra expense for them. And I'm talking about Jennifer Renard, who is Next Step English. So here's what you guys can do to thank them for being such awesome people and to learn from some of the greatest teachers and people I've ever met. You've got Suzanne at English Smarts. So follow English Smarts on Instagram, Twitter as well. And Next Step English, which is Jennifer. They both helped me tremendously when I was starting Patreon. They helped me with the podcast. I sent it to them because I valued their opinion. So a lot of R&D, research and development. And not only that, they were there for me since day one. Jennifer was my first patron. So Jennifer, Next Step English, lots of love. My wife is a patron too. Yeah, well, hey, you know, why not? You got to support the family, right? You say in Spanish, barrer para casa. I think you say, right? It's a great expression. All right. Well, guys, I want to wrap up now. I don't know how long we've been here on the air, but if you guys have any questions, I know some people asked some questions before. But in order, so I don't have to scroll up, maybe I already answered those questions. Does anybody have any questions about FYI, about the show with no name, about, another free thing. Claro, se me olvida. So many different things. Every week on Instagram, you have like a power pack workout with me. Un entrenamiento a tope. 10-minute workout with me every week on Instagram. Again, I do more on other Instagrams than on mine. Well, I'm working, you know, so with Vaughn, I'm on Grupo Vaughn every morning, the show with no name. But once a week, I'm on Lara Alvarez's Instagram, and Lara Alvarez is a very famous TV presenter in Spain, and I'm her English teacher. So she asked me to collaborate in a section called Aliados. And I said, of course. And so you have 10, this is this week, I think the 9th class is coming out. So that's 90 minutes. And in each video, you're going to learn like 20, 30, 40 words. So pretty amazing, I must say. Pretty amazing. That said, my amigos, any questions? You really have all the tools, all the resources you need to take your English to the next level. And you know what? You also need patience. Patience. Yeah, when you see these guys, hablo ocho idiomas, soy el jefe de Obama, you know, vas a aprender inglés en ocho palabras, en ocho días. It doesn't work like that, guys. That's so, when you hear shit like that, run away. Huye, and run fast, because it's a scam. Es un timo. This is not a one-week process. It's not a one-year process. It's a process that you will go throughout your life. And that is so important, and myself as well. I had a class this morning with one of my patrons. David, if you're there, what's up? And we were talking about this, you know, about how even me preparing the podcast, I am learning new words in English every day. I said it correctly, in English. So if I'm 43 years old now, and I'm learning words still and concepts in my own language, well, there's no reason you can. And as I said, one of the cool things about FYI is, aside from learning, you know, vocabulary, the present perfect, whatever, all these kind of cool little expressions, you're also learning about a topic. And it's going to help you become better at conversation, right? You'll be able to talk about a lot of different topics. And as I said on the last episode, many of these topics are not controversial. I always try and find a little controversial angle or something like that, but in general, they aren't controversial. So guys, tons of free things. You got Patreon, which you got something for all budgets over there. If you want to join us, we'd love to see you. If you have any questions, contact me. If you want samples, let me know as well. And really, the best and last piece of advice I can give you is, make sure you're following those people I mentioned, English Smarts, Next Step English. Make sure you're following me. Make sure you're subscribed to all kinds of different, Vaughn Radio, all these things. Because if you're subscribed, if you're following these people on social media, you don't have to do anything. Well, yeah, you have to read the posts and you have to, you know, you have to kind of go over the material, but it comes to you. It's never been easier to get English on your lap, right? At your doorstep, como decimos. Okay, Jesus says, I got a little bit depressed this week since I had to talk via telephone with a native English person. Could you give us some advices? Primero es advice, nunca con ese. There you go, Jesus. Could you give us some advice when it comes to talking through the phone? We would say talking on the phone, mejor. Practice, buddy, practice, and learn the different parts of a telephone call. By the way, last month's masterclass was on telephone communication. So, Jesus, you haven't seen that. Are you a patron? If you're a patron, you should have access. Well, the superstar students have access. And the super duper students and intergalactic students are actually in the class. So check it out. Check out that video. You'll be able to find it. Remember, too, I have a YouTube page. I mean, so many resources. So guys, make this the year. Now the summer's coming up in a little bit. Make this the year that you say, you know what? Okay, I haven't mastered English. No he dominado el inglés. But why do we need to master it? Why do we have to control everything? Why can't we just accept English? Why can't we just, you know, make it part of our lives? And then it's not like a, once I beat this demon, you know, cuando venzo este demonio, you know, it's like, don't make it your enemy. Make English your friend. And how do you do that? By having fun. And that's why in all my podcasts, you'll catch me singing. And on that note, no sé cómo se dice en español, on that note, vamos a ver, on that note, on that note, vamos a ver, eso es, y con esto último, o con respecto a esto último. And I think now's a good time to say goodbye, but we'll do it, you know, using song, con una canción. Are you guys up for it? Now let's see if you know me well. I want to say happy Good Friday, and I want to say bye, 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 or in sync. I don't care who's wrong or right, make this seem alright, making up the words now, come on. Everybody sing with me, leave again, I don't think I can take no more. I came to see you out that door.